Alright, well, it's finally a beautiful day here in, well, I call it hell, but everyone else calls it Utica. It's the first time we've seen the sun in 3 years, and, I just went to the hobby shop and grabbed some extra parts for my, Blade 400, and I'm gonna take it out for a spin. Here's some things that I think are important to let you know if you ever plan on buying a Blade 400. There's certain things that they don't really include in the kit that they really kind of should. But what I would recommend is first of all, you want to buy an extra power, an AC-DC power adapter for your LiPo charger. Because that is not included, it only includes alligator clips for a battery. And what I actually did was I actually went out and bought this, which is supposedly a better LiPo charger, which is a Passport Ultra. I haven't gotten to try it out yet, but it looks pretty good. Also, I went out and grabbed a higher capacity battery, which, let me see my other one. This is actually, from what I understand, this one's actually, I don't think you can see it, but it's a little blurry, sorry about that. This one's actually, not the same one that came with it. I actually had a defective battery, so I had to go and, in case you can't see that, it is a little blurry. It's 11.1 volts, 1800 milliamps. And then this one is actually 2100 milliamps, so it gives you a little bit more flight time. As well as a shoulder strap for your new DX6i. It's just a standard Spectrum shoulder strap. They do not come with any sort of lanyard in the ready to fly package. So that's what I just went out and grabbed one. What I would recommend, though, because this was about $12, if you don't want to spend that kind of money on it, you can just go out and actually I'll show you what I have on mine now. As you can just get a little simple lanyard like that, and you can buy a lanyard for a few cents at like pretty much anywhere, you know, Walmart, Best Buy. I'm thinking of different video. Walmart, you know, Lowe's, you know, you can buy them for a few cents. And so this is actually the one from my college. So actually, I'm going to be taking that off. So I'm going to be trying to see if there's going to be any way if I could, you know, I'm using my camera phone because I can't find my other, my real camera. So I'm going to try to find a way to see if I can find a way to record myself flying, but I don't know if I'll be able to prop it up. Actually, fortunately, I don't know if you can see that very well. It looks like it's getting pretty windy out here. The trees are actually moving, so I don't know if I'm going to be doing any flying today. But all right, well, I got this stuff. So those are some things you might want to take a look into getting. The flight package is pretty much complete for the Ready to Fly Blade 400, but those are just some little oversights that I found. You know, it shouldn't make you not buy it, but it is kind of annoying, you know. So, all right, well, see you later.